Emergency crews are bracing for a night of wild weather. Forecasters predict damaging gale force winds and hail over the next 18 hours. Kate Freeband joins us from Outer Harbour. Kate, how bad could it get tonight?
Well, Beck, the Weather Bureau's told me that Adelaide could get some of the wildest weather seen in about 2 years. It's relatively calm here at Outer Harbour right now, but a significant cold front has moved up through the Bight and it's headed our way. Now, it's expected Adelaide could get wind gusts of up to 90 kilometres an hour and in some parts along the coast up to 120 kilometres an hour. And we're also expecting some significant rain. Between now and lunchtime tomorrow, Adelaide could get up to 20 mils, and the Mount Lofty Ranges and parts of the lower southeast could see up to 40 millimetres. Now, a severe weather warning is in place for those damaging winds and emergency crews are on high alert. They're expecting a very busy night.
Hours before the main front hits, strong winds are already buffeting the Adelaide Hills. This tree falling across the main Stirling to Allgate Road this afternoon, blocking traffic for more than an hour. And even this morning, it was only the Hardy who took on Mount Lofty. Conditions also unfriendly on the freeway, but this was just a curtain raiser to the main event, with the Bureau warning of approaching wind gusts in excess of 120 kilometres an hour.
This cold front could be one of the more significant, one of the most significant perhaps, that we've seen for the last 2 or 3 years.
The change expected to slam into areas south of Adelaide and the Mount Lofty Ranges from around 7 p.m, while the planes could also be in the firing line.
And the more significant gusts coming out of those storms, the damage could be quite significant but localised.
As winds started picking up along the Fleurieu coast this afternoon, the State Emergency Service issued an extreme weather warning. They want motorists to watch out for falling trees and householders to secure or remove loose items from outside.
Making sure that items that could get blown around in these severe winds that are forecast are tied down so that they don't become projectiles.
The front also likely to bring driving rain, hail and localised flooding.
It's perhaps 20 to 40 millimetres up in the Adelaide Hills, and if you get hit by more than one thunderstorm, so 2 or 3, possibly even 40 to 60 millimetres in some isolated locations.
James Wakeland, 10 News.
While the worst of the weather should pass by about midnight tonight, heavy showers and strong winds will continue right through to about lunchtime tomorrow. And there is the chance of small hail right across the southern part of the state, including Adelaide, tonight and into tomorrow morning. Beck.
I'll speak to you a bit later on. Thanks very much, Kate. So conditions along Adelaide's suburban coast are expected to become wild later tonight. Joe Hill is braving the elements at West Beach. Joe, how does it look down there right now?
Beck, it's a bit of a different picture here to what we saw Kate dealing with. The wind is certainly picking up. It's currently blowing from the north to the south, but what's going to happen in the next couple of hours is it's going to do a full 180 and blow that storm back in over the city. You can see it there behind me. It's very dark and there's a lot of rain coming out of those clouds, but it's not just the wind and the rain that this pressure system's bringing. It's also bringing quite a big tide. Now, the Department of Environment has spent the day down here shifting sand and creating something of a sand wall to prevent sand erosion that the tide's going to cause. It was initially slated to be 2.8 metres at its highest at about 6 o'clock tonight, but with the wind and the pressure system, that's more likely to be at about 3.6 metres, which just falls shy of the Bureau's high seas warning. But Beck, this storm, it's certainly whipping up. We're going to be here for a bit longer yet, and I'll see you at 5:30 for an update.
If you don't get washed off the rocks. Thanks, Joe. Joe Hill reporting live.